You always play the same opening. Nothing is ever the same if you think about it. Oh, please don't. Well, am I wrong? Nothing is ever the same, is it? Everything changes. You want to go down that road, okay. So when you say everything changes, are you referring to Rockley's concept about the flowing river Pantarei? Why do you think I have to be referring to anything? I'm just saying, even though I play the same opening every time, we haven't had a chess game that nearly resembles the previous. Even if we had played the same game, it would make us feel differently about it. Because if something is really identical with another, then it would make the same impression every time. If something really exists, that is. So, if I was referring to someone's concept, it would be Georgia's. Alright, so you agree with Georgia's that nothing exists. But identical things make a different impression because the ones that are influenced change. If anything really exists whatsoever. Well, if something is experiencing changes, then something must, in fact, exist. What if it is true that our senses are lying to us? We might think there are things, and those things experience changes, but those could just be made up images in our heads. What about Descartes' maxim? I think, therefore I am. Yes, but I only find the outside world's existence troubling. You realize that your statements are contradictory, right? Have you ever thought about going outside this room? I understand that we should not trust our senses without any doubt. But if we live in full doubt, we wouldn't be able to find meaning in anything. Or even playing this game or having this conversation if there is nothing to it than smoke and mirrors. I'm not certain that everything lacks existence, nor in the opposite. So you basically disagree with Sartre that everything has a compulsive way of existing?
Don't involve the continentals.
Okay, what about Wittgenstein then?
What about him?
The limits of my language means the meanings of my world.
To agree with that statement is to go back and agree with George's. So yes, I could accept that there is something in everything that makes it as is what it is. And I also accept that we as limited creatures could not understand those things, and thus we are not able to talk about them.
I think we can both agree on that.
And yet, I feel like as we accept it, we say to ourselves that we should not even try to understand the world that we live in.
You said it yourself, what good is trying if you already know the outcome?
Well, how can you be certain?